Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question, which says that evaluate tan of sin inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 2 by 3. We know that tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy, provided xy is less than 1. With this key idea, let us proceed with the solution. We are given the expression tan of sin inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 2 by 3. Here, we shall convert sin inverse of 4 by 5 and cos inverse of 2 by 3 in terms of tan inverse function. First of all, let us assume sin inverse of 4 by 5 d theta, which implies that 4 by 5 is equal to sin of theta, or we can write sin theta is equal to 4 by 5. In a triangle ABC, if theta is the angle between the lines AC and CB, we know that sin theta is given by perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is AB by AC, which will be equal to 4 by 5. Now, if perpendicular AB is given as 4 and hypotenuse AC is given as 5, then we can find the value of the base BC by using Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have the value of the base BC is given by square root of hypotenuse AC square minus perpendicular AB square, which is equal to square root of 5 square minus 4 square, that is square root of 25 minus 16, which is equal to square root of 9, that is 3. So we have base BC as 3. Now we know that cos of theta is given by base upon hypotenuse, that is BC upon AC, which is equal to 3 by 5, and tan of angle theta is given by sin theta by cos theta, which is equal to 4 by 5 whole upon 3 by 5. Therefore, tan theta is given by 4 by 3, which implies that theta is equal to tan inverse of 4 by 3. Now we have sin inverse of 4 by 5 equal to theta, and theta is equal to tan inverse of 4 by 3, which implies that sin inverse of 4 by 5 is equal to tan inverse of 4 by 3. Now again, let us assume that cos inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to 5, which implies that 2 by 3 is equal to cos of 5, or we can write cos of 5 is equal to 2 by 3. In a triangle PQR, if phi is the angle between the lines PR and RQ, then cos of angle phi is given by base upon hypotenuse, that is RQ upon RP, which is equal to 2 by 3. Now, if we are given the value of the base RQ as 2, and the value of the hypotenuse RP as 3, then we can find the value of the perpendicular PQ by using Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have perpendicular PQ is equal to square root of hypotenuse RP square minus base RQ square, which is equal to square root of 3 square minus 2 square, that is square root of 9 minus 4, which is equal to square root of 5. Therefore, the value of the perpendicular PQ is square root of 5, and we know that sine of angle phi is given by perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is PQ upon PR, which is equal to square root of 5 by 3, and tan of phi is given by sin phi by cos phi, which is equal to square root of 5 by 3 whole upon 2 by 3. Therefore, tan of phi is given by square root of 5 by 2, which implies that phi is given by tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2. Now we have cos inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to phi, and phi is equal to tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2, which implies that cos inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2. So now we have sin inverse of 4 by 5 is equal to tan inverse of 4 by 3, and cos inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2. So we can replace sin inverse of 4 by 5 with tan inverse of 4 by 3 and cos inverse of 2 by 3 with tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2 in the given expression. And hence we get tan of sin inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 2 by 3 is equal to tan of tan inverse of 4 by 3 plus tan inverse of square root of 5 by 2. Using the key idea, we have tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy, provided x into y is less than 1. Here we assume 4 by 3 as x and square root of 5 by 2 as y. So we can write tan of tan inverse of 4 by 3 plus square root of 5 by 2 upon 1 minus 4 by 3 into square root of 5 by 2, where x into y should be less than 1, that is 4 by 3 into square root of 5 by 2 should be less than 1, that is 2 into square root of 5 by 3 should be less than 1, which is true. So we get tan of tan inverse of 8 plus 3 square root of 5 by 6 whole upon 1 minus 4 square root of 5 by 6, which is equal to tan of tan inverse of 8 plus 3 square root of 5 upon 6 minus 4 square root of 5, which is equal to 8 plus 3 square root of 5 upon 6 minus 4 square root of 5. On rationalizing this expression, we get 8 plus 3 square root of 5 upon 6 minus 4 square root of 5 into 6 plus 4 square root of 5 upon 6 plus 4 square root of 5, which can be written as 8 plus 3 square root of 5 into 6 plus 4 square root of 5 whole upon 6 square minus 4 square root of 5 square, which is equal to 48 plus 32 square root of 5 plus 18 square root of 5 plus 60 whole upon 36 minus 80, which is equal to 108 plus 50 square root of 5 upon minus of 44, which on further simplification can be written as minus of 54 plus 25 square root of 5 upon 22. Therefore, the value of the expression tan of sin inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 2 by 3 is given by minus of 54 plus 25 square root of 5 whole upon 22, which is the required answer. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.